now up to 3, and in Newark we've had an inch of snow. We've had bursts of snow, and I think that is what's been typical of this area of low pressure, is that it continues to march up the dark pink and purple. That's where we've seen the 3 to 6 inch bands of snow, and as the low continues to track up the coast, we will see additional snows. Winter storm warnings now will be sleet sitting back where we have the enhanced yellows. Philly still snowing. Baltimore, D.C. now, you're starting to taper off, and you really shouldn't see any additional accumulations in and around Baltimore and D.C., just some flurries lingering about. New York in through the Hamptons, White Plains, and up on through Hartford. We have the snow coming in, and we'll continue to see the snow over the next several hours through this area. Could pick up an additional couple of inches of snow. As we talked about, now moving on into Boston and Worcester and Providence. So as we check back in with Jeff over the next couple of hours, we're going to see the
into the Northeast. But I got to tell you, folks, after looking at this and then looking at this, you get a lot better definition of where the heavy snow is. You can see the Doppler here out of Philadelphia showing still a band of heavy snow in downtown Philadelphia right now, moving through this little ribbon here, extending north to Trenton. Trenton and Wrightstown are just getting hammered. They're sitting in this band of very, very heavy snow right now, and they are getting it. And I mean, you know, 1-2 inches an hour. There's probably about 5 inches on the ground right now at Wrightstown. Still snowing at Atlantic City across the Delmarva, starting to taper off a little bit across Maryland and southwestern Delaware. But you can see this heavy ribbon of snow heading in. Still the tri-state area getting hammered. Heavier snow now is pushing into northern New Jersey and up through the New England Thruway as well. So now we got to look at New York City, and you can see across Long Island we have all snow in through here. Heavier ribbon of snow up through, let's say, Glastonbury and heading up into the Connecticut Valley here around Springfield and Chicopee Falls. And as Jody and Jeff were talking about, you can see the snow now coming into the Boston area, mostly light. But there are a couple of dark green patches here, and this is some heavier snow. So if you're heading southwest of Boston, looks like the heavier snow will kind of fill in from the west side. And we've already seen times Worcester go down to a mile in visibility. So some interesting weather with regards to the Boston area this morning. Down to the south with the tail end of this storm.
This is a special edition of WeatherScope with the latest winter storm update.
Good morning and thanks so much. The winter of 96 continues. Very, very busy here at the Weather Channel. We are seeing one storm system after another, always on a weekend. That's the way it always seems. But the good thing is we're not having to deal with any sort of rush hour, folks rushing about. Let's show you real quick where the area of low pressure, the latest area of low pressure is. And it's hard to see, but it's off the Hatteras coastline right now, and it continues to throw moisture back. We've had reports of moderate snows. If you live around Bradley Field in through Westfield, South Weymouth, we've had reports of about 3/8 of a mile visibility and moderate snows at times. And with this storm system, we've been seeing bursts of snow. Now again, Atlantic City, you're back into a burst of snow with a half a mile visibility. Philly, about a quarter mile visibility with heavy snow. So you're going to see bursts of snow. It's going to pass on by. Another shot of heavy snow comes through. And that's what we are dealing with this storm system. Now we have been certainly watching this busy winter. It has been a record-setting winter in New York City. We'll talk about that in a moment. But first, we want to turn to Jeff Morrow, who is in the Boston metro area. We were talking to Jeff all morning long. He was standing out there, and it was very dry. And now I see a few snowflakes, Jeff.
Yeah, it really still hasn't picked up here yet, Jody, but for the folks around Boston, it's just another weekend snowstorm of this very busy winter. Unlike New York, which has already set their all-time seasonal snowfall record, Boston still has a little ways to go. The record being up about 96.5 inches, I believe. We're at 83.5 inches right now here around Boston, and we're expecting about 3 to 6 inches total from this particular storm. It hasn't started sticking yet. It's still just a very light snow, just flurries really. But again, we're expecting it to pick up and look like these scenes, which we can show you now, I believe, from around the New York City area. These shots taken around Times Square a little bit earlier, where there was some very, very heavy snow. And this, of course, is as they were setting the seasonal snowfall record there in New York. So it's just another snowstorm. Not the biggest one, obviously, to come up the East Coast. That still has to go back to the blizzard back in January. But just another one that's just adding to the winter woes here in the Northeast. And I think a lot of people in the Northeast, particularly around Boston here, are getting a little bit tired of the snow. But they know that spring still is right around the corner, about a couple of weeks away. So I guess that's the light at the end of the tunnel here.
I think what's annoying, Jeff, is sometimes when we've had such a busy winter, then it gets really warm as it has been, and there's no snow on the ground yet, and here comes more snow. Do you think folks are getting a little tired of it?
Oh, yeah, they're definitely tired of it, but they realize that this snowstorm is just a 3 to 6 inch snowstorm for Boston is just another snowstorm. I mean, it's not going to cripple the city or anything, and they're pretty much prepared for it. And the fact that, again, that's happening on the weekend will help out, that people don't have to do the commute. By the time Monday rolls around, I'm sure everything will be fine here around Boston once again.
All right, Jeff, well, we'll check back with you, and the snow bursts will be moving into Boston as we head on through the morning hours. So
okay.
Thank you for that report. And that, once again, was Jeff Morrow. He was in the Boston area. And we have snow as far north now as Chicopee Falls. It's been snowing around Martha's Vineyard and then through Providence. So the snow is on the move, but just light flurries as we just saw in Boston. But you're under a snow advisory. You could pick up about 3 to 5 inches of snow. Let's show you some graphics as to what is going on. And in fact, we have the snow history that's going on here. We've got about 3 to 6 inches of snow that we've seen picked up on the New Jersey shoreline down to the Delmarva. Some heavier snows. Exact amounts for you? Well, we've had about 6 inches of snow around Ocean City, New Jersey. A viewer called in and let us know that was going on. About 4 inches around JFK, and of course enough to set the record. 3 inches in Dover, 3 as well in Baltimore, and about 2 at LaGuardia. So just enough probably to cause some slowdowns out there on the runways. Now, as of 8 a.m., on this Saturday, New York City did beat the record. 63.8 inches of snow picked up in the New York City area. This is at Central Park now. It makes it the snowiest season on record since we started records way back when, 47, 48. That was a busy season, but not as busy as it has been. And compared to average, you can see that we are just way above average on that note. Boston, as Jeff mentioned, we are not going to see 13 inches of snow in Boston. Certainly not that much. We saw a tremendous season when we had all those nor'easters back in 93, 94. Not going to get that much, but we certainly are going to see about 4 or 5 inches of snow. Let's show you real quick what we do anticipate. Areas in white under...
If any of you guys are in Boston watching us this morning, which I know a lot of you are, go by and see Jeff at the Commons and ask him to bring me back some cannolis. I mean, tell him to go up to the North End and bring me back some cannolis. That would be so sweet. Thank you very much. Anyway, what's going on here as we take you to Jersey, on up into Long Island, across into Connecticut. You can see our snow expanding northward. But to get a better look at this area, the Doppler radar really shows the most intense area of snows. And you can still see that across much of South Jersey. 6 inches already at Ocean City. Wrightstown has got to be real close. You can still see this dark green band affecting the Trenton area. Here's Philly, still some moderate snow there. And all this is just continuing to expand off to the northeast. As Jody and Jeff were talking about, we've already broken our record in Central Park for the snowiest winter on record. Would have been real cool to have a little party today in Central Park, huh? Commemorating all that. Here's the Doppler picking up sleet just offshore here. That's why you're getting these reflectivity. I mean, sleet being a lot more reflective, so it almost looks like real, real heavy, intense rain, but this is actually sleet in this particular storm situation. Notice again the snow up through northern New Jersey, across Long Island as well, and on up into Connecticut. And that snow has expanded, as Jeff and Jody were talking about, into the Boston area. Manchester, some light snow already. How about that? We got a little burst of snow here just moving into the 495 loop. Looks like it's going to head right north toward Methuen and on up into the Boston area. Again, you can see the snow continuing, and the snows and the rains actually increase on the coast. We got rain now at Nantucket Island. Some thunderstorms moving onshore with some special marine warnings out around Bonita Springs and in the Everglades. And you can see these storms are producing some lightning.
Roadways being reported through the Delmarva. We've had reports of about 4 inches of snow now around JFK and New York City, of course, beating their snowiest winter on record coming in this morning with surpassing the old record back in 47-48. The snows will continue to march up the eastern seaboard up throughout Maine. Interstate 95 will be snowy today and windy too. And as we look on into tomorrow, the clipper that's moving through the Midwest and the lakes will push on toward the northeast. Snowy travel, lake snow advisory is in effect off of Lake Michigan. We're going to see some heavier snows here. And showers across Florida from Orlando all the way down on through Tampa, Daytona, and Miami. And even a few thunderstorms, a possibility on the tail end of the front.